Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will talk about rounding and how it affects your robot paths. Let's get started. Rounding, blending, zone data, continuous motion, this feature has many names depending on the robot brand you're used to. In a few words, rounding is a way to keep as much velocity as possible while passing through many points with your robot tool. In this video, I will show you how robots generally handle that and how RoboDK handles that internally. Instead of going to RoboDK directly this time, we will go to a simple whiteboard. So here I have a small representation of a normal path. Let's say that you are starting at P1 and your goal is to reach P2 and P3 using linear motion. The normal program would look a bit like that. So move L P2 followed by move L P3. If you don't add any description or any option to the path, it would be considered what I would call a fine motion, meaning that you need to stop at each point. So if I go here, I will simply call it fine here for the moment. So every time I need to reach a point, the robot will stop at point 2 and then it will stop at point 3. So if I was to draw real quick the velocity profile, it would look a bit like that. So constant acceleration up until a point where I reach the requested max speed or Vmax in fact, followed by a plateau, followed by a constant deceleration. So it's what we call a trapezoidal velocity profile. So constant acceleration, max speed, constant deceleration. So here I have my P1 or my starting point, and then here I'm reaching P2 at the end. Then I'm starting the same thing all over again. Constant acceleration, plateau or max speed, and then deceleration to reach P3. So here P2 up to P3. If I add a blending, let's say here I'm adding a blending to the first motion. So blending will be expressed in different ways. Some will express blending or rounding or zone data or continuous motion as a radius in millimeters. Some will express it as a percentage. Some will just consider that it's either constant motion or fine motion. So it really depends on the robot brand you are using. So I would recommend you maybe taking a look at the documentation of your specific robot brand to better understand that part. So here, let's say that we go for a brand that would use millimeters. So this is the easiest, let's say, explanation I can give you to begin with. So let's call that here simply R equal 5 millimeters. So what does that mean is here we would create, I will zoom in a bit. We would create kind of a imaginary zone around, oops, I could have done a better circle than that. An imaginary zone around P2. And as soon as my tool will come here and hit that zone, which is obviously 5 millimeter, the radius is 5 millimeters. Instead of following the path as if I had a fine motion, it will start to interpolate here. So it will start to interpolate. It might not reach P2 in any meaning. In fact, it might not reach P2, but it will make sure to keep as much velocity as possible when going from point 1 to point 2. So the speed profile or the velocity profile, instead of looking like that, so acceleration, constant speed, deceleration, acceleration, constant speed, deceleration, will look simply like that here. It will keep as much speed as possible. There won't be any acceleration here. It will keep as much speed as possible here up until when it reached P3. So here, this one here, as we don't have any other motion or point afterwards, we're kind of forced to use a fine motion because we'll have to stop here. We don't know where we would go after, so we can't keep any speed with us. We can have conservation of speed if we don't know where we're going afterwards. We need to decelerate. But for P2, we will keep as much velocity as possible from one point to the other. So that's one method. Other brands will use percentage. So it might be instead of R 5 millimeters, it might be like, 20%. Generally, what that means, like it will take the distance between 0.1 and 0.2, and it will start interpolating when we are at 20% of the distance between those two here. So when we've done like 80% of the distance, we'll start our interpolation from one point to the other, just like that here. It's more like a curve than a line. I have a hard time drawing. I'm an engineer, not an artist, but you get the point. So the goal here again is to keep as much velocity as possible so that your path is smooth. This has some limitations, obviously, like physical limitations. If you have a setup like this where you go from 0.1 to 0.2 to 0.3, here as you're really changing direction, at some point you will have a slowdown here, because like physically speaking, you can't go in one direction and then go back in the other direction and never slow down in any way. So that wouldn't work physically speaking. So that's for like the theoretical part of how rounding works in robotics. Here, if we open our simulation tool here, so 07F, I'm gonna reduce the size of those targets. I have a pick and place program here. So it's simply, in fact, it's a pick and place. It's more like going to all the corner. So if I just run that here with the TM, just moving from one point to the other. Awesome, just like that. Here, I don't have any rounding anywhere. So I'm always going from a full stop to I'm accelerating, going to the next point, and then full stop, and then so on and so forth. So if I want to add the rounding in RoboDK, I just have to right click, add instruction. And then I have here set rounding instruction. So here by default, it will be -1. If I do -1, it's accurate. Accurate meaning that I will stop at each point. If I right click edit, I can enter here either a radius or a percentage. In this case, I will go simply for, let's say, 10. And you will see here a naming, so it will change the name from accurate to smooth 10. So inside RoboDK, using smooth 1 or smooth 1000 won't have any impact on how the robot behaves. It will only have an impact on what kind of program you will generate and that you can load on the controller. So that's again something that you need to kind of know what your controller needs or how it works to better understand which information you need to give it here. So within RoboDK, if you are using a smooth motion, it will always keep 100% of the velocity. Even if you have a change of direction that is like completely in one direction and then the other, it will keep the full speed. So that's something to keep in mind, especially when in the next two videos, we'll talk about cycle time analysis. So that's something to keep in mind. So if I run that here, you will see the difference between before and now. So it's a bit faster, because here we are keeping 100% of our velocity. We don't have to stop at each point. Also, I have to show you here. So if you don't have a smooth 10 option here, or either accurate or smooth here, if you go to the robot panel and you click on parameters, you will see here you have a rounding value. So this is the value, the rounding applied to the path. So even if I was to remove that here and run the program, I would still have the rounding 10, because here it's applied to my robot parameter. If I right click, I'm gonna wait for it to stop, right click, add instruction, set rounding instruction, and then -1, so accurate. If I run it like that, if I go to parameters, you will see that now I have -1. So what you are applying here will apply to the general parameters of the robot. So that's something to keep in mind. So you can always go and check at what rounding you are. So this also applies to the speed. We'll discuss that in the next video. So that's pretty much everything for this one. I really want you to understand how rounding works in the concept works in robotics, and then how it's applied in RoboDK is fairly simple. So you either have accurate or rounding or smoothed movements, if I can say. So it's either you go to a standstill at each point, or you keep 100% of your velocity. So that's, like I said, just something to keep in mind. In the next video, we will talk about speed and acceleration. That's another topic that is quite important, especially if you want to do applications like welding, dispensing, or cutting, where the speed of the tool with respect to your part is quite important for a good, let's say, product, finished product. And also, if you're interested in having an accurate or as accurate as possible cycle time estimation. I hope to see you there. In any case, have a great day, guys. Thank you.